There are days when you are sad, and there are days when you are really, really sad. Thankfully, over the years, I have learned that it's okay to be sad, and it's perfectly normal to feel something, anything, because after all, sadness needs to exist for us to be able to feel and appreciate peace and happiness. Here are 6 things I do for when I am feeling really, really sad. We all feel down in the dumps sometimes. We have good and bad days. If I feel sad, then I prefer to go outside and then it really feel little better. Once I get outdoor, I start to feel stronger and more energized. Playing with friends can get my mind off from the troubles and make me laugh. And before I realize it, the sadness has gone away. Daydream, unstuck yourself, explore, clear your mind and get some vitamin D on your face. This can honestly take shape in any form. Self-care went out of the window because of all the anger and frustration it would pile onto myself for being anything other than happy. But I have learned that to love myself means to love and accept the inevitable sadness within me too, and to treat myself every once in a while. The key here though is to put away all the distractions and focus on the present, that is eating this delicious thing right in front of me. Quality time to me means to focus undivided attention with the TV off and phones put aside, by being fully present, actively listening and actively participating. It could be something as simple as bike riding, to cooking, to spending time with family. It's a happy time. Music is known to reduce stress, help deal with depression. Classical meditative sounds seem to be particularly uplifting and elevate mood. Music also helps people perform better in controlling their high blood pressure and in reducing anxiety. Everyone has lots of feelings. Some makes us feel good and some brings us down. It's good to express your feelings, especially those that leave you feel sad. That means letting your feelings out or showing or telling others how you feel. Write it down why you are angry with your best friend or how you can tackle your big project. You can also draw what you are sad about or draw a picture that shows how you wish things could be. Be spontaneous and surprise yourself. Whatever, it's something you have been meaning to do, like checking out that place you have been meaning to check out, reading that book you have been meaning to read, go to that restaurant, go to the museum, go take the yoga boot camp that you have been eyeing to, go to the beach, go see your parents. Whatever it is, when I finally get around to do something I have been wanting to do, be it in professional or personal context. I hope you guys feel a little less sad if you are sad, and if any of you guys are really, really sad. I just want you to know that you are not alone, that we all go through it too. And let me know how and what you do when you are sad. I will see you guys in the next video. Take care. Bye bye.